Hello and welcome to Conquering Alba, where we take you to the historical places that help make Scotland what it is today. Today we're in the southern part of the Isle of Bute as we visit St Blane's Church. St Blane's Church has its roots in a monastery founded here in the 500s AD. The church was the home of St Blane, or Fair Blane of King Garth, who may have been buried here upon his death. The structures on the site belong to two eras: that early Christian monastery, abandoned during the Viking raids around the 790 AD, and later a parish church built in the 1100s, and was in use until the Protestant Reformation of 1560. The ruined church sits nestled in a valley at the southern end of the Isle of Bute and boasts views that stretch as far as the Isle of Arran and the Holy Isle.
Thank you.
There has been a religious site here since the 500s, when St. Catan established a monastery which was eventually abandoned in the wake of the Viking raids. St. Blane was a bishop and confessor in Scotland. He was born on Isle of Bute, although his date of birth is unknown. In some late medieval Scottish texts, relate that his mother was Irish and that St. Cathan was her brother. It was Cathan who saw to Blane's education in Ireland under Saints Comgall and Kenneth. Blane eventually became a monk and went to Scotland and was eventually a bishop among the Picts. An apparent story of St. Blane is that he had transported some holy earth from Rome. He asked a native woman to assist him, although she refused. Because of this, after his church was erected, he enacted that no women were to obtain burial in his cemetery beside the men. An adjoining piece of ground was assigned to females, and this was custom of separate burial survived until 1661. When it was stopped by an injunction of the Presbytery of Dunoon. Some surviving remnants of that our 1400-year-old monastery include the stone wall separating the secular world from the spiritual, foundations of numerous circular buildings, a well, and a stone base which would have once supported a stone cross. The remains of St Blane's Chapel are surprisingly extensive, with the nave and part of the chancel dating back to the 1200s. In the upper cemetery stands the ruins of Kingarth Parish Church. Built in the mid-1100s, its Romanesque architecture, particularly in the 1300s chancel arch, are exceptional. In the southern part of the churchyard contains a number of weathered grave slabs, including a distinctive hog's back gravestone from the time when Bute was part of the Norse Empire. The cemeteries at St Blane's remained in use for a long time. The rectangular footing at the southwest corner of the site probably represent the remains of the parsonage or manse. hope you have enjoyed today's video here at St Blane's Church. The church is one of the best preserved of the surviving early Christian sites on Bute. It is a beautiful building and has many beautiful sites all around it. If you have enjoyed today's video, please like and subscribe for more of Scotland's history, and until next time, Alba go bra.